Jimmy.
Today I'm going to do a cool experiment that you can do at home. All you need is a glass of water, an ice cube, a match, and a little bit of salt. Okay, so you have your glass of water. You take an ice cube and stick it right in there like that. I'll put the flat side facing up. Okay. And then you tell your friends, "Hey, I bet I can lift that ice cube out of the glass with this match." And your friends are going to be like, "Oh, yeah, right. He can't do that." And then you start to demonstrate. So you have your ice cube, and then you want to stick it right in the middle, put your match right on top of the ice cube, like with one side sticking out. So you hold it like that, so it'll look like that in the water. So you stick that right on top. Okay, and then you take a pinch of salt and sprinkle it right on the top of it. Just like that. And then you can wait a few seconds. It doesn't take very long. And then you grab the end of the match and lift it right out of there. So what's going on that makes this happen? When the ice cube is in the water, it's beginning to melt. There's water molecules leaving the ice, or melting, as well as molecules from the liquid getting frozen back onto the ice. So the ice cube and the liquid in the glass are in a state of equilibrium.
Equilibrium.
Now adding salt changes everything. Even though there's salt on the ice, the ice cube is still melting at the same rate as before, but the water around the ice is now diluted by the salt, making it harder for the water molecules to get refrozen back onto the ice. As this process takes place, the rapid melting of the ice requires a lot of energy. This energy comes from the heat that's in the ice and in the water, thus making the ice and the water colder. So how come we can lift the ice cube with the match? It's because there's no salt between the ice cube and the match. It's just clean water. And since the salt has lowered the temperature of both the ice and the water, it doesn't have any problem refreezing between the ice cube and the match. Thank you for watching this experiment. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Also, if you have any ideas for future experiments that I could do, leave them in the comments below or connect with me on Facebook, Twitter, or Google+.